Right. Here's the situation. We have our phones, and we have our Windows 11 PCs. Neat! But sadly, that's usually where the story ends. What if we could merge them together? What if I were to tell you that for $0 and for downloading zero new apps, you could turn these two devices into one? Let me show you. Okay, looks like nothing urgent. Good, let's sit down and focus. Here we go. I'm gonna open up Outlook. I'm gonna open up PowerPoint. I'm gonna go into Word. I'm gonna open up Facebook. Excel and stuff. I'm a productivity powerhouse. Uh-oh, I've just felt it. Did you? The buzz from your pants? A text has come in. Let's see if anything important. Oh, let me just reply real quick, okay? Hold on, here we go. Just gonna send this up. Okay, great, good. That's been dealt with. Put this back in my pocket and back to whatever I was working on. I'm sure it was important. Go tab through my apps. What was it? What was I doing? And on and on and on and on and on and on. Does this sound familiar to you? Let me just tell you, if you have an Android phone, virtually all of these issues completely vanish. And even if you have an iPhone, a lot of the features I'm about to show you, they'll work for you too. I'll be sure to put a note on the screen to let you know which features I show you work for Android and iPhone or both. So let me walk you through it here. I'll show you some of the features first, and then I'll walk you through how to do the initial setup to link your phone and your PC together at the end.
And opening phone link is super easy. Just hit the start button here. So start typing phone link and up it comes. And I'm able to see basically everything that's going on my phone, but on my PC. In fact, I can even click here on apps at the top and I can actually open an app like, hey, maybe I want to jump back into my crossword puzzle that I was working on my phone. I can just click this and look, it's like my phone is running on my computer itself. And I can hop back in and start working on today's crossword. Okay, or you can do something less nerdy than this, like, you know, open a different app. But for me, I'm gonna stick with the crosswords for now. This is so cool to have my phone like living on my computer like this. But let's say I wanna get to this app even faster from my phone, right? But I wanna see it on my computer. So again, if I just go back here to my apps list, I right click on the app, I can add it to favorites. And then look at this, it's quickly right there available to me. I can do that with multiple apps there, like my podcast app. Maybe I want to just hop back into a podcast that I was listening to on my phone. Well, watch this. I can even make it faster. Add to start. Yeah, that's right. So now when I hit my start menu, that app is right there ready to be launched and I can hop back into my podcast. And for me, the best part about this is it keeps you in your flow. Like no matter what app I open, whether it's a park ground advising app or whatever, I can be using that app while I'm using the rest of my PC just like normal. In fact, I can even just like snap that app over there. And now I'm able to organize my whole workflow around having that app open all the time, just like a normal Windows PC app. Playing around with apps is certainly really impressive and fun, but I think I get the most use out of Phone Link simply by replying to text messages. Like, here we go. I can just choose a text message thread and I can go here and reply just like this. But I can also just throw in a GIF real quick. And the best part about this is I'm using my PC keyboard, right? I'm not having to get my phone out of my pocket at all. I'm just typing and it's sending from my phone. And I never had to leave my workflow. I just minimize Phone Link and I'm back into my normal workflow. And this really does make it so much easier for everyday tasks, like searching through your text messages. Like someone sent me a cute picture of something my daughter made outside. I think they called it like a loom, a weaving loom or something. So I'll just search my messages for the word loom and boom, there it is. And there's the picture I was looking for. Like super simple. We've all been there. You're working, you're in your flow, you're multitasking. And then of course the inevitable happens. Aha. The text message comes right in. Well, guess what? Without having to switch to my phone, without having to switch apps, I can just reply right here. Hit enter, and I've replied to the text message. I never had to pull my phone out of my pocket. I didn't even have to switch apps on my PC, and I'm back here, back at my work, never being interrupted. That's kind of the power of Phone Link in a nutshell. And it goes beyond just text messages. Did you know you can actually make full-fledged phone calls right here within PhoneLink? Watch this. Let's see what Kyle's up to. So I'm actually going to be able to use my PC speakers, and I can actually just make a phone call right there.
You're in speakerphone.
Oh my gosh, he actually answered. I got to get back to my workflow. Answering a text message is one thing, but also you can be in the middle of your workflow and a full-fledged phone call comes right in. Well, here we go. I can either send a quick text message in response, or I can accept on my PC. And this feature gets really useful in areas you don't really expect, because let's say you're just browsing around and you need to make a call to a business. So here we go. If I hit call, it'll actually say, do you want to use PhoneLink? I'm like, heck yeah. I click that. It's already put in the number for me. I just have to hit go.
It's a wonderful day at Rosen Inn, closest to Universal.
There's actually a lot you can do in this notifications part of the PhoneLink app. So you can clear a notification, of course. You can clear all of them, which is actually quite handy if you've got a whole lot like I happen to right now. But you can do individual actions too. Like I can just delete this email right here. Look, it actually deleted it from my Outlook inbox. I can reply to emails straight from here. I can reply to text messages right from here, or other kind of apps as well. Like here's an Instagram link or an Instagram reel that my friend Tony sent me. I can actually reply right here without ever watching the reel. Watch this. Wow, so funny. Thanks for the quality share. Super smiley face. He'll never know. Okay, that was kind of cruel, but you get the idea. You can interact with these however you like based on whatever the app supports, or I can just click on any of them and be taken straight to the app itself. In fact, there's so much to think about when thinking about notifications that it's worth actually just taking a moment and managing them directly. So just click settings here in PhoneLink, and you can actually click on notifications. And you can specify if you want it hidden, if you want to show the content of it. And you can even go down deep into the features themselves and click notifications here. And here you can really fine tune what notifications you see, which apps you get notifications from, all as detailed as you want to be with your notification settings. It's really simple. You want to check out your photos that are on your phone, but you're on your PC? Just open PhoneLink and hit the photos button in the top. And look, there's that selfie I just took. I can click it, I can open it, I can edit it, I can share it, I can even delete it from my phone right here from my PC. It's pretty cool. You can do some other magical things too. Like if you have a photo with a lot of text on it, well, actually right here, there's a text button. And right now you can see it extracted the text. I can actually select all the text and there it is. I can copy it and I can go ahead and paste it into, well, let's see, I'm working on stuff anyway, right? Let's just pop open Word and I can just paste that text right there. And it actually did it really well. I just can manage the formatting and add it to my newsletter. That was really fast. So what's this little area for? Well, it gives you vital information about your phone, right? Battery life, connectivity, Bluetooth, all that stuff. In fact, right here, you can just click on your phone and you know what it'll do? It'll open your phone. But like really, you can actually use your whole phone just like this. You can open up apps, you can scroll back and forth and interact with it. You can open up the camera, do whatever you want, check your notifications this way, even though you already have it here, so why would you? But that's not the point here. So you can open your phone screen right like that, great. But also from here, you can check out the connectivity. So one click, you can see that, okay, it was last updated really recently. You can also toggle this really important switch called sync over mobile data. This means if you don't really care about how much mobile data you're using, or if you have a lot to spare, you can be connected to your phone through PhoneLink without even needing your phone to be connected to Wi-Fi. So even if your phone is miles away from you, as long as it's connected to its normal data connection, you can use all these features in PhoneLink on your computer. It's like having your phone with you no matter where you go or how far away you are from it. We use different devices to do different things. Like, I'm having a conversation with my friend about the different comedy sketches we both like, and I want to find the link to it. So I'm going to open up YouTube here, and I'm going to see, okay, here's the sketch. I want to share this. I want to share this video here. So let's go ahead and hit share, and then I'll just copy that link. Now, I've just hit copy, right? That's all I've done. And watch this. It's pretty downright magical, because if I go over to my PC, I don't have to click anything. I don't have to sync or anything, right? I just say, here's the sketch we're talking about. And then I just hit paste. And it pasted it from my phone. It just knew, because I enabled copy paste across devices. See, if you go here in the settings, you can actually enable under features, cross-device copy and paste. Allow phone link to access and transfer content that I copy and paste between my mobile device and my PC. That's magical. It really is all about keeping you in your workflow, because even things like entertainment, like maybe you're listening to a podcast or listening to some music, you can even play and pause and manage that right here from within phone link.
Stone tools were part of our progress towards...
Here's how you manage which devices you're connected to with PhoneLink. If you just hit the settings button right here, you'll land on the general settings page, and then hit devices. This is where you manage, maybe you can even remove the phone that you have selected, or add another one, or add the first one. Add device, the all important question, is your device an Android or an iPhone? Choose the answer, and then you'll be greeted with a simple QR code for you to scan with either your Android or your iOS device that will take you to the proper configuration settings for either iOS or Android, and you'll get yourself paired up and working in about a couple minutes.
And that about does it. I'm telling you, once you start using PhoneLink, there's really no going back. Your stress levels will thank you. Your sense of zen and calm will thank you. But most importantly, your pocket elasticity, well, we'll really thank you. Okay, now I just need to go make more friends so I actually have someone to call.